Thanksgiving, make your request known to God. Then the peace of God that surpasses all understanding will guard your hearts and minds in Christ Jesus. Finally, brothers, whatever is true, whatever is honorable, whatever is just, whatever is pure, whatever is lovely, whatever is gracious, if there's any excellence, if there's anything worthy of praise, think about these things. Keep on doing what you have learned and received and heard and seen in me. Then the God of peace will be with you. And with your spirit.
Thank you. Jesus. bound and hung and set upon it, and it is written, Fear not more, O daughter of Zion, see, your king comes, sit upon an donkey's colt. His disciples did not understand this at first, but when Jesus had been glorified, they remembered again that these things were written about him, and that they had done for him like this. So the crowd that was with him, when he called Lazarus from the tomb and raised him from the dead, continued to testify. This was why the crowd went to meet him, because they heard that he had done
Це мене не повинно нас здивувати зовсім.
che sono la parola per Saulo, per Saulo se dà già cosa ci vuole. Ma io c'è tu, il suo, a volte cosa ci posso ricordo, il Saulo. E il Dio se dire, per Saulo il Mahano che mi dice di Dio, e può voi, se il Rosalino, e per Saulo dice, se il Ciao, mi Mahano che mi dica, ma cani, oltre il Ciao, si può dare, Nami Dio nami se ne stiti, che si malo se ne ungaggio, e se ne lo prodolosi, disto di Paolo in Europa, jak sarà, jak to jeszcze ma je prytnie. Oni go lo witali, i nic to było preopomne, radosti. Це знако, ця подія у історії, але спасіння, вона є настільки важливою, і настільки гарною, прекрасною, значною, що ми досвідчуємо і святуємо кожного разу, коли ми святуємо службу Божу. Це якийсь час ми будемо всі бачити, як буде відбуватися Божий вхід. Як буде священник брати дари, які виготовлені на посконодійнику, і перевести через світ, так, у ці двері, і перевести через ці великі царські двері, і поставити їх на престіл. Це є символізм того дня, того моменту, коли Христос проноситься, Він переходить і Він лишається за просторі, щоб бути пожертвований. І навіть якщо ми зауважимо, пам'ятаємо слова Слова Божого, зразу після того входу, кожен буде сприймати, що ми це на все не прийняли, що його слави не буде проводити мати свідчення. Алелуя, алелуя, алелуя. Саме цей момент радості, що ті всі люди переживали в Єрусалимі понад 2000 років, ми переживаємо з вами під час служби Божої. Саме це і відбувається. Але застановіться собі трішки над тими словами, що ті люди воскресали, говорили у той час, коли Христос приходив до міста. Осанна, благословений той, хто є ім'я Господнє. Осанна. Це єврейське слово. Воно значить «Господи, спаси мене». «Господи, спаси мене». То є дуже гарне і доречне фраза про слово «Осанна». І надалі то є той возглас радості «Осанна, спаси мене, Господи». У ті моменти нашого життя зараз і тепер, скільки ми, скільки з нас, саме це ми хочемо сказати. Саме сьогодні ми це свято. «Осанна, Господи, спаси мене, спаси нас усі». Бо наскільки ми потребуємо Його спасіння. Спасіння від чого? Звичайно ж, ми всі зараз переживаємо і дуже журимося за цей вірус, коронавірус, що йде у цьому світі. Тому ми всі є позаникнені у наших домівках, і ми чекаємо, поки воно не перейде. Але в душі, в нашому серці, ми хочемо сказати, останнє, спаси мене, Господи. Так, я не перетерплю, це зараз і не так, але нам потрібно Твого спасіння. Визволи нас від того, від Твої хвороби. Ті люди рідні, що лишають так по лікарні, по цілому світі, вони так само розповідають, останнє, спаси мене, Господи. Буде їй тяжко пережити. Тяжко пережити тут хворобу. Особливо, коли кажеш, що найбільшим симптомом є того, що тобі замикається легені, ти не можеш дихати у той час. Осанна, спаси мене, Господи. Скільки тих осанна ми можемо почути і уявити собі, що люди в вуст, в серце і думок, тих медсестер, лікарів, по цілому світі. І вони це говорять не тільки тому, що вони надзвичайно перемучені, але тому, що вони саме є ті, що бачать цю печаль, цю трагедію, ті стогни чули від тих людей, коли вони мають бачити тих людей, що, на жаль, виходять з цього світу.
Виглядає, весь час поможує і поможує, і нема спасіння ні від того. Останнє, спаси мене, о Господи, дай мені Твою ласку щодня. Дай мені терпеливість, дай мені мати Твою любов. Дай мені мати постійну віру, так як Ти навчав, коли Ти був разом з нами тут на землі. Коли люди приходили у безвір'ї і поверталися додому саме з вірою. Останнє, спаси нас, Господи. Ми віруємо, що Ти є завжди з нами. Ми віруємо, що Ти ніколи не покинеш нас. Ми віруємо, що Ти є цар і Бог. Таким, як Ти прийшов, таким, як Ти був, коли Ти був між нами, і залишаєшся завжди з нами. І ми просимо Тебе сьогодні, не тільки нас спасти нас, але так само просимо, що Ти завжди напоминав нас, що Ти є з нами. Що навіть зважаючи на те, що відбувається, можливо, виглядає, що тьмень, така сірість є у тому житті, ми пам'ятали завжди, що після тьмені завжди приходить світло. Завжди приходить світло. І так як завжди ми будемо святкувати з вами святе Воскресіння Христове, так само і воскресне наша душа. Воскресне наше серце, воскресне наше життя і розум. І наступні неділі ми будемо всі забавом святкувати Твоє Воскресіння і казати Христос воскрес і смерті, що ти з тим співом воскресло нашої душі. Як нам було потрібно? Як нам було потрібно? І сьогодні на право ми повинні подякувати Божому покровінню, що саме сьогодні, за тих декілька тижнів, будучи запертими в наших домах, ми святкуємо з вами. Наступні неділі ми будемо святкувати Христове Воскресіння. Це надало піднімає наш дух, піднімає нашу віру. Подякуємо нашому Господеві, що Він є завжди з нами, що Його свято, що ми Його святкуємо, надало значить наш час. І цього року святкування чи вікної неділі, чи навіть Воскресіння Господнього наступної неділі буде особливим. Не буде таким, як усе. Але це для нас є і урок. Найбільше того, що можливо все не так іде, як ми хочемо, але Бог завжди незмінно є завжди з нами. І любов нас спасти. Останнє, Господи.
If you can recall the passage from the Gospel of Luke, chapter 24, and the next time it occurs in the middle of the chapter, there is a story about two men walking from the city of Jerusalem to Emmaus. It was another kind of small town outside of Jerusalem there, and it talks about resurrected Jesus, the risen Jesus that walks along with them, and he was wondering what those two men were talking about. And those two men were kind of very surprised, and they said to him kind of, "And are you the only foreigner? Are you the only man that doesn't know what ever happened in the city of Jerusalem these days?" And Jesus, kind of pretending that he doesn't know anything, he actually said, "No, I don't. Tell me about it." While there was this Jesus that he thought that he would be the king of Israel, the leader of our country, but our elders actually betrayed him, crucified him. And now we heard that he is actually risen from the dead. Imagine that those two men actually were saying exactly what many people were experiencing and were thinking at the time in the city of Jerusalem. Because it is true, as today we are celebrating the entrance into Jerusalem of Jesus Christ, he was welcomed as a king. He was welcomed as as God. He was welcomed as the one who many expected to be their leader. And this is why he walked into the city of Jerusalem, as the Gospel of Mark would actually Jonathan, and he is writing in along with the with his apostles, his army, if you will, and they walk into the city. And many people were rejoicing at the time, and the gospel keeps on talking about it all the time. How men and women and children were screaming and shouting, cutting off all branches, taking all their own clothing, lying down on the road there to welcome the king. But not everyone was happy about it. And this is the thing, that there are two interpretations of whatever was going on in the city of Jerusalem at the time. It was whatever people have seen and experienced, and that what Christ was witnessing and experiencing himself. Because people, whenever they were walking out and they wanted to see Christ, they wanted to welcome him, they wanted to welcome him as the king, as the one who was going to come, the one that the prophets were talking about, that they are going to rebuild the glory of Jerusalem. They built the Cathedral the way it was, during the days of King David and Solomon, his father, his son. And it did not happen that way. It didn't. This is why even those two apostles, the two disciples that were walking from Jerusalem to Emmaus, they were surprised. We thought that he would be the one who was going to renew and rebuild Israel. And it did not turn out that way. But the realization of that is going to come in later, 5 days later, when the same kind of crowd that were shouting, that was shouting, Hosanna, blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord, will be screaming, crucify him. Get away with him. We don't want him anymore. We are disappointed. Get someone else. Isn't it interesting? But this is how people actually saw it. This is how they will see it. And when it comes to Christ, he knew as to what is going to happen with him. And he accepted the joy of the procession of the people rejoicing there, because there were also people that were welcoming him as not just king, but also as God, as the Messiah. They were welcoming him. Because finally, that what many prophets were prophesying for centuries, finally is coming all about. They are witnessing. And imagine what a privilege it is to witness the fulfillment of that that was spoken about for centuries. It was happening. And he let it all know that same people that were shouting Hosanna, later on they wanted to be screaming, crucifying him, get away with him. He is a nobody. He knew about it, but here he did not protest it at all. He accepted it. Many people did not like the way he entered into Jerusalem, because they began remembering the emperors and how they entered into the city of Rome. How come he is doing that? Who is he? We don't want any kings around here. We don't want any tsars around. We have Romans here. What if Romans are going to see it? They are going to come in and they are going to destroy us all here. We don't want that at all. And this is why many of the elders that were serving, that were in charge of the Hebrew nation, this is why they started to wonder if this Jesus is not going to cause any more problems for them. And Jesus showed it in. Because the next day after he entered the city of Jerusalem, he showed up again the next and the following day afterwards as well. This is why he overturned the tables that were of money changers and sours and birds and different animals there for sacrifice. He overturned it all. He chased them away there. Because he told them right away, this is not what my father's house should be looking like at all. They felt even more angry with Christ. Also, also it happened that they came to know how he actually got anointed with a precious oil. This is not the privilege of everyone. Only to the kings that it belong the privilege to be anointed with a precious oil. This is why if we recall the passage from the Gospel of John, it talks about this very costly perfume that cost 300 denarii. That's quite a bit of money. I know exactly the person actually this about $500. Can anyone spare that? Not at all. It's only to the very privileged that it was that it belonged to be anointed with such perfume. And this is why they started to think once again, who is he to whom all these privileges are being done? This is why people were filling up more and more with hate. And it was hatred that actually caused Christ to be betrayed and also crucified on the cross. Today's feast is only the beginning of that culmination. And in the following days, we're going to hear the Gospel Passion Narrative once again, and we will hear how everything kind of seems to be getting darker and darker and darker. But we all know even saying that it's always the darkest before the dawn. And same thing in the history of salvation. Exactly on Good Friday, when everyone thought, almost everyone thought, that it's all finished, that it's all done, that he actually can't be away. Not at all. Because exactly from a week from now, we're going to be celebrating Christ's resurrection. We're going to celebrate the Feast of Peace, the Festival of Festivals, the Feast of Light, Christ's light, that will enlighten the world, that will enlighten us all. The kind of light that we need here and right now, in the midst of that darkness, in the midst of that uncertainty, and even disappointments. This is why I'm so happy, we are all thrilled, that we have this holiday, that we have Palm Sunday, that we celebrate the solemn entrance of Jesus Christ into Jerusalem, especially today, to be the lift up to our spirit. And kind of to remind ourselves that not everything is over. We all have our crucibles, perhaps from last year, we still have it in our homes as well. Find it and hold on to it. Hold it for a moment there, and even say it as well as the children of Jerusalem were saying today, Hosanna, blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. And we'll see how our spirits will perk up. How we will change, how we will become kind of filled with joy again, which St. Paul is saying in today's first reading of Philippians that we heard today. No, it's not over by any means. It all shall pass, and the day will come when we all will come to our churches once again, and we are going to become the Tuesday rose, and we are going to be rejoicing. We're going to be happy again that we are back in the Lord's house, that we can come and pray to Him once more. Welcome Him in that Word of God, and also welcome Him in the blessed sacraments. We can do that, and it will happen for sure. And for now, I wish you all a happy and blessed Holy Week, and so the next Sunday, we can all say Christ is risen, Christos was Christ, and Hosanna. Blessed is he who comes, in the name of the Lord.
Thank you. compassion, we pray with your risen mercy.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
We also pray for our most holy universal Pontiff of Francis, Pope of Rome, our most blessed Patriarch Svetoslav, our most reverend Metropolitan Archbishop Boris, our God-loving Bishop Andrei, for those who serve and have served in this holy church, for our spiritual fathers, and for all our brethren in Christ.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
We also pray for our nation and our God, for our government and for all the military.
Francis, but of God, almost was patriots and a swan, almost hermit of poet and grace. All the prince did a young and virtuous orders, our nation of God, our government, and also military. That all never to be remembered, founders and benefactors of this holy church, and all of your virtuous Christians, always now and forever.
From the Father, with the Father and the Son, is worshipped.
fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with all of you.
The Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
may glorify and bless thee the praises of your most sacred and sacred name, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and forever and ever.
And may the mercies of the great God and Savior Jesus Christ be with all of you.
Thank you.
Save your people, O God, and bless your name. always now and forever and ever.
Господеві, помолімся.
О, Lord, our God, seated on the cherubim, you exalted your strength and sent your only begotten Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, to save the world by his cross, burial, and resurrection. And today, as he goes, this is voluntary passion in Jerusalem. The people who sat in darkness and the shadow of death go out to meet him, and taking up the emblems of risen life, both of trees and branches of palms, they signify his resurrection. O Master, bless these branches of pussy willows and preserve us as we imitate them, holding branches and palms in our hands on this pre-festive day, like the nation and the children who offered Christ our Hosanna, grant that we too, singing songs and hymns, may attain his life-giving resurrection on the third day. And with him, O Father, you are blessed together with your all holy, good, and life-giving Spirit, now and always and forever and ever.
Также займем присутствием, як завжди, а згоди тож всім, хто сьогодні наживо молиться разом з нами. Прошу привітати вас цим величним святом, святом пальмової неділі, квітки неділі, які ми святуємо разом з небесами, єднаючись зі вами через засоби масової інформації. Хотів би в цих надзвичайних умовах ще раз відповідати і дивитися за інформацією про цей тиждень страсний, де будемо святкувати, продовжуючи таких надзвичайних умовах, де ми молимося у Господні храмах, духовенство, а наші вірні, молячись в своїх домівках, у своїй домашній церкві, єднаються з нами через засоби масової інформації. Отже, ми коротенько про Господа на цей наступний тиждень. У понеділок, вівторок і в середу будемо мати ввечері послухання літургії на Предсвятій Зорі о 6:30 вечора. Покатку до цього у середу буде молитва зцілення. У четвер, 10:00 зранку, буде вечірня з літургією архієрейською Святого Василя Великого. У четвер вечір, 6:30, буде утрення страстей, це читання 12 Євангелій, в страсну четвер вечір, 6:30. У страсну п'ятницю, в 3 годині, ми будемо мати послухання вечірньої і також виставлення своїх пашниць. У 7 вечорі запрошую всіх знову-таки через з'єднання на живу трансляції на послухання Євангелії утрення. У суботу зранку у нас в годині буде знову вечірня з архієрейською літургією Святого Василя Великого. Послухання Святого Воскресіння Христового на той тиждень неділю. У 8 годині зранку буде послухання Народного, також Воскресна утрення і в 9 годині приблизно буде архієрейська Святого Воскресна Божесна літургія на годи свята Воскресіння Христового. Також нагадаю, що бачите на Фейсбуці оголошення нашого проповідника про те, що будемо мати онлайн наживо трансляцію реколекцій, місць. І розклад є наступний. Сьогодні в першій годині в нас у вашій катедрі розпочати ці реколекції нашим проповідником. Це буде на українській мові. Також сьогодні у 7:30 ввечері буде наступна наука по-англійськи. У понеділок завтра о 12:30 зранку у резиденції на Кополичі наука по-українськи і в 6:00 ввечері тут у нас в академії наука по-англійськи. У вівторок, це третій і останній день реколекції, у 11:30 зранку знову ж таки українська наука на Кополичі резиденції і у 6 вечорі тут в катері перед послухінням буде наука кінцева на англійській мові, рекреаційна наука нашого Кополича. Якась лайк щодо Resurrection of our Lord, Easter, at 8 a.m. the start of the service of the Holy Spirit. approximately at 9 a.m. there will be a hierarchical divine liturgy on the glorious feast of resurrection for our Lord. Also, I would like to announce that this, starting today, we'll have for 3 days special missions presented to us by our Metropolitan Archbishop, who is starting today at 1 p.m. The our cathedral here, there will be a first sermon in Ukrainian at 1 p.m. And 7:30 p.m. today, there will be a second sermon in English. 7:30 p.m. at the cathedral here today. Tomorrow at 11:30 a.m. at the Metropolitan's residence, the chapel will be first sermon tomorrow in Ukrainian. And at 6 p.m. tomorrow afternoon, for the service of presenting the liturgy, there will be the second sermon in English by our Metropolitan Priest. On Tuesday, the third and last day of the mission, we will have again at 11:30 a.m. At the Metropolitan Residence Chapel, sermon in Ukrainian, and including sermon in English will be at 6 p.m. at the cathedral in here before the services. Будучи вдовна відстані, то ми, що вдовна від десятків